Amanda and I are so proud of Georgia. She's such a lovely young lady. I can't, I'm so excited. I can't even see because my glasses are all wet. I could say so many things about Georgia, and believe me, they would all be nice because she's the nicest, most incredible person. With the biggest heart. Well, with the biggest heart possible. And she looks absolutely amazing today. Sam, shut up, you milk. I promised Amanda I wouldn't cry today. We'll have proper fucked that up already. Sorry, Amanda. As most of you know, I'm quite an emotional person. So I'll try to keep this short and I'll leave all the funny stuff to Mitchell and Matt. I do remember when Georgia and Matt first got together almost 10 years ago. Matt would arrive at our house every Friday after work and would leave every Sunday night. Matt would only go home once him and Georgia had eaten and drunk everything in the fridge, the cupboards, and especially the treat drawer, which Matt loved more than anything else. I said to Amanda, when these two move out, you never know, we might get something to eat ourselves. As you can see, I did. Little did we know, though, they would buy a house just down the road and still come over every fucking weekend and eat everything that we've got. But to be perfectly honest, we would never change a thing because we love them both so much. Just wipe my nose. This bit's a bit easy because it's a lie. Matt, myself, Amanda and Darcy would officially like to welcome you to our family. Even though you've been part of our family for a long time, you've also become a very good friend to us all. Now I can officially call you my son-in-law instead of playing golf and going, that's George's boyfriend. I'd just also like to take a moment to remember the family members that are no longer with us. Like George's granddad Bob, and Matthew's nan Joan, and of course all the other family and friends that are all sadly missed that are no longer with us. Oh, that is the worst part. I've not got no funnies left either. I must say it's fantastic to have all of you here today to help us celebrate this special day. Oh my God. So we could all just raise our glasses and say massive congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Brigland.
Cheers, Jamie, that was quite nice.
That's the easiest thing I've ever done in my life.
Or I probably should say, cheers, Jamie, that was really nice. Unfortunately, I don't cry, so that's going to be a real... If you were that emotional, this would be really shit in comparison. Sorry? And why is it just talk like this, or... Harry, can you hear me okay? Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Wood has made his way here early tonight. Harry Wood, everyone! I did edit his invite for 8 o'clock, but he's made it here at fucking 6:30, but there you go.
He never got to school on time.
No, very true, naughty. Right, this is 6 pages, as you'll see, but I'll try and ramble through it as quickly as I can and we'll go from there. But just want to start off by saying this wedding, for the rest of the evening, is a strictly no football affair. We're not talking about football at all. All of my family is Spurs. All of George's family is Arsenal. Yeah. The last thing I want to hear is how Arsenal are 8 points clear with 6 games to go. Bottled the league. Drew 3 times in a row, brought out a song called North London Whatever, and ended up coming 3rd, I think, in the end. So absolutely no football, if we can do that start away. But just to echo what Jamie said about the people that aren't here today, George's granddad Bob, who I never got to meet, but I have been told he was absolutely an amazing man. Bob's wife is here, Jeanette, with us today. George's nan. I wish I did get a chance to meet him, and I wish he would have grown to love me. And to be honest, beating Jamie would have been a piece of piss, so it should have been absolutely okay. And also to my beautiful nanny Joan, who Georgia did get to meet. Georgia, my nan was incredibly fond of you, and I can remember one summer's day whilst we were having a midday sherry out on the balcony, she said, Matt, I think Georgia is really good for you. I said, Nan, why is that? She said, I've never heard someone that can make you shut up and let someone else speak. She said, when Georgia talks, you stop and you listen. So from that point on, I knew that Georgia's going to be the one. So Grandad, I think you have a sherry here. So if you could just do a little toast for me. And if everyone could do a toast with the glasses they've got, that'd be amazing. Thank you very much. All right, let's get rid of that. What's the next page? Oh, I did put on there. Anyone who backed me to cry during my speech at 9-1, that was your only chance. It's probably not going to happen. I'd like to thank my beautiful auntie Tracy sitting here. Up until last week, Georgia had no dresses. And I think we were all a little bit nervous. But they came in okay. And as we can all agree, Georgia looks absolutely beautiful. So yeah, that's absolutely great. Go on, Tracy. Yeah, Tracy. Wow. Cool. A lot of clapping. Emily. So when I got these suits, Emily, what I look like? Absolute sack of shit. But because of you, you've made me look absolutely 100. Yeah, look really good tonight. So anyone needs any alterations, please ask Emily. She's the lady sitting in the far corner over there. She'll definitely be able to do it for you. Chloe, is he in there? Give us a wave. No way. So Chloe gave up her morning to make all the bridesmaids look as good as they do today and then got herself ready. So if we can all say thank you to Chloe for giving up her time. And then lastly to Ryan. Ryan Garner, sorry, but he's all come up with it. Ryan Garner sitting there, spent until about 12:30 last night doing all the grooms, and that's us, yeah. Doing all of our hair, making us all look amazing. So again, Garner, thank you very much for your time and dedication. The hen girls sitting around over there. that was Shannon, Amanda. There's no point asking, is there? No, you all gave George an amazing send-off. She had an amazing time, so thank you very much for that. Bridesmaids, or the three bridesmaids that aren't now related to me, so Libby, Caitlin and Steph sitting over there. You all look beautiful, so well done. Sabby, you're not crying, are you? Well done, it's fucking double hard work, but Chloe done it for us. I can imagine it's not been easy for Georgia, being with me for the past 10 years. I'm sure she'd have leant on you at some point to give her comfort and say, we'll get better. So thank you very much. Whether that's happened yet, I don't know. Has it? No?
Not this week.
Not this week, no. Right, family. So I've put here that I woke up with three sisters. Oh, sorry, I woke up with one sister. Fucked it already. What have you not told me? Fuck's sake, I can't read. I've never done English. Woke up with one sister, now I have three, which is very cute, the girls sitting here. I didn't really want one, so having three is an absolute pain in the ass, in all honesty. Megan, I'll start with you. It's lovely how close we have become. And I gave you a note earlier. I'm very glad that we don't pretend to not notice each other like we used to, walking down to the train. And I just want to thank you for bringing Ryan into my life. Because, quite frankly, if you two break up, there's a good chance I'll spend more time with him than you. So, yeah, just so you know. Oh, fuck, where's the next page? All right, who've got next? Bridie. Thank you for being the joint maid of honour. Thank you for being an amazing sister to Georgia, and thank you once again for picking Mason, because again, I don't know why you two are here, because really it's these two are the stars of the show. Same thing as Ryan, don't be shocked to find me and Mason going out more and more and leaving you behind, so you two might want to become friends, because the three of us are going to be out quite a lot. And then Darcy, lastly, you made it to the head table, so you must be the most special.
I'm adopted, everyone. No,
I do. Yeah, no, we did. I do truly love the four people I just mentioned, Darcy, but quite frankly, I'd drop kick them all off a bridge if it meant I had to save you. You are the favourite. Riz would be close, but you are the favourite. We built a relationship over our love of Marvel films, but I wouldn't change that for the world, and it's been amazing for all of us to watch you as the baby of the family growing up. So well done, Darcy. Aww. Seven pages left. Dad? Or as the lads over there know him as, thumbs up Andy. Nice and simple. Don't get much more than that. Thank you for all the help you've been over the years. You raised a son who was quite frankly useless at anything DIY. You raised a son who put up one mirror in his new house with no more nails and was awoken at 3 a.m. by a loud bang and the sound of glass shattering. But you was a great help for me and Georgia, who moved into the house, and even more recently, giving me your car when I took on a new challenge and a new job. So I do really appreciate that. So thanks, Dad. Give him a clap though for me, yeah. Mum, I'd like to thank you for raising such a well-mannered, funny, charming, And most importantly, a very humble son. You've been an amazing mum to Megan and I, and I know we don't thank you enough and should thank you more. So in front of everyone here, I would like to personally thank you. So thank you very much. Thank you as well for turning up to A&E last Saturday at 4 a.m. I can't go into more details, I'm sure Mitchell will, but when I was asleep across the 3 chairs and you woke me up, it was a bit of a shock. So yeah.
Just
right, this side of the room. I'll come back to Mitch. Jamie? You're right. Amanda. That's right. You had 3 tries to get a son, and although as a child, Darcy looked like a Chinese boy, you still never managed it. You've been a great father-in-law to me for 10 years. You got me into golf, which quite frankly, I love more than Georgia.
Thank you.
And you're an amazing father to the girls, and I know every one of us look up to you very much. So Jamie, thank you very much. It took a lot for him to do that speech, so yeah, that was amazing. Amanda, could I ask for a better mother-in-law? I don't think so. Granted, as Jamie said, I gained 3 stone the first 18 months I was with Georgia, as your portion sizes are roughly that a fully grown elephant would eat. But no, it's been amazing. And if Georgia can grow up to be anything like you, then I've got an amazing wife coming for many years to come. All right. What's that? Well, you're still laughing, so it must be all right. So I'm just eating the mic at the minute.
What?
Is that better? Well, that was... fucking bollocks. Right, now you've made me lose where I am. Oh, groomsmen. Thank you, all groomsmen. It's a shame you're all 6'3", which doesn't make me look any good, which is a bit unideal. But all the hard work you've put in giving Mitch your hand for the stag has been most much appreciated. And if any of you boys need help, I'd more than happy to do it for any one of you. So thank you very much. Have they been helpful or?
No.
Is that a lie?
No, it's a lie.
Right, don't clap the groomsmen, fucking. The stag boys, we've got the stag boys sitting over there, got some of the stag boys here over there. Getting 16 people to Dubai was absolutely unbelievable, something I never thought would happen. And the fact you would treat me to a skydive over the Palm was one of the best moments of my life up until sort of 2:30 today. I had the winner at Ascot, so. I think we all had an amazing time from start to finish. We've won Alessio sized bump on the first night. But I do really appreciate all of you. And as far for the home stag, who a lot more of you are there, Mitchell, I'm sure we'll go into that in more detail, but I can't say too much. I can't remember a thing that happened, in all honesty. Right, what have we got next? Oh, my best man, Mitch. I think we're excited to hear what you've got to say, although for every 1 story of me you've got, I've got about 15 of you. So just bear that in mind, Esther, if the chance comes around. Mitch and I built our relationship over weekend Nando's and losing £20 on accumulators. 10 years on, not much has changed. I still eat the same butterfly chicken meal, and Millwall still can't win me a 5-fold at 3 o'clock. So thanks very much to Millwall. You've been a great friend. We've had some great memories together. So thank you for being there and being up here with me today and everything you've done from the stag and beyond. So thank you very much for that. Right, the last bit. Georgia Victoria Brigland, my newly crowned wife. It's a fucking honour. I was going to make a couple of jokes, but this is going to be very serious, so this is going to be the only time I'm serious. Georgia and I can't fully remember when and how we met. I can, however, remember taking Georgia to Miller and Carter after she got her A-level results. I got myself all dressed up in my finest River Island cardigan and top Mancinos. I got in my little red Fiat Punto with my Aux tape recording playing Chris Brown, who I found out was her favourite artist, and I picked her up. I knew Georgia was the girl for me when, after studying the whole menu, she picked the fish, which I instantly worked out was the cheapest thing, in Miller and Carter. Fair to say, since then, it's not been quite like that, has it? Wagyu beef and all that sort of shit. Oh no, that's all good. When Georgia and I were first together, she worked at Tesco's, and I can remember on a Saturday, she would have her break at about 5 o'clock. So each week at 4, I would drive to McDonald's, get a McFlurry, go to the Tesco frozen aisle, and leave a McFlurry for her behind the veg. I'm a fucking legend. She still owes me a fiver from yesterday. Proposing to Georgia in the Maldives was the best moment of my life until today. Even when I was trying to get her to the proposal location, she insisted on going to the toilet, and after not speaking to me for 5 minutes, she told me she was taking her makeup off when I had a photographer waiting outside on the beach to get the good shots. So that was not ideal. Good news though, the photographer, who was hiding inside a bush at the time on the beach, forgot to take the cap off of his lens. So I done the whole thing, I'm on one knee doing it, giving all the spiel and that. He comes out the bush, oh my God, Mr. Bigland, I forgot. And he had nothing, no photos, nothing at all. So everything we'd done was completely fake and we had to redo it again. But we got some good shots, even if both my knees were a bit sandy. I fell in love with Georgia very early on and I've never once looked back. Georgia, you make me a better person every day. And because of you, I want to be the best version of myself. Because of you, I want to strive towards getting the finer things in life. And because of you, something I never thought I'd say, I want to one day become a dad.
Aww. I've copied all of this in Ross's name. From that guy.
Georgia, I can promise you I'm going to be a pain in the years to come. I'm going to make comments I instantly regret, and I'm going to make mistakes. I'm going to forget to do the most simple task you tell me, but I promise by having you to help me overcome every obstacle and having you fight my corner against the world, I'll try to make our lives as good as they can be. You see the best in me when no one else does, and you love me through all my faults, and without you, I truly have no reason to be here. You are the most beautiful person inside and out, and I'm so lucky to have you all to myself. So ladies and gentlemen, if you can please raise a glass and give a very big cheer to my beautiful wife, Georgia Brigley.
Turn it up. Samuel, Samuel. Right, here we go. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm feeling extra nervous today, as Matt has already told me that if I do a good job here, I could be the best man at his next wedding as well. Now, I'm Mitchell, I'm Matt's best man, and I'm very honoured to be here today, standing by my best friend and his beautiful bride on a very special day. Now, there comes a time in everyone's life when they meet their one true love, their soulmate, the person they're going to know and love for the rest of their life. Now, that came from Matt 15 years ago when he met me. Over the years, we've shared a lot of memories together, some good, some bad, some very bad. From late night trips to the casino, shuffling in nightclubs, and even clocking up over 100 Nandos in 1 year. Watching you randomly being sick for no reason at every boy's trip away, and spending endless hours with you watching any football game that we can find. Now, mine and Matt's relationship really grew around football, and for the best part of 10 years, I would be there week in, week out, throughout rain and slow to watch him play. And despite many own goals, countless yellow cards, seeing you score the winning penalty to win the League Cup was a real proud dad moment. Now, despite both sharing a massive love for football, there's still some question marks around our knowledge of the game. Let me take you back to August 2014. Me and Matt got tickets to see Spurs play Limassol in the Europa League. On entry to the stadium, we saw the lineups and noticed that Jermaine Defoe had been replaced in the warm-up by a young 20-year-old Harry Kane. Me and Matt sat there slating him for 90 minutes. We couldn't believe that Spurs had played this overweight, slow, brain-dead striker. And after watching him miss a penalty, we had seen enough. Skip forward 9 years. We have become overweight, slow and brain-dead. And Harry Kane's become one of the Premier League's greatest ever strikers. So safe to say, mate, we're both as clueless as each other. Big shout out to all the boys who came to the stag. I know it meant a lot to Matt, and he's very grateful that you could all come. The stag was a great weekend, despite most people spending their entire budget on the first night. Thanks to Alessio, who ordered a £3,500 bottle of vodka just as we were about to leave. Luckily, Adam managed to save the bottle with help from me and Ryan. We managed to sneak it out of the club, into the cab, and back to the apartment. And 4,407 miles later, we've actually got it here. So, Adam, come and get it. That's for you. Take it. So, yeah, I know it meant a lot to you. That was fucking expensive. However, as funny as this sounds, obviously we left the club, returned to the apartment with the biggest bottle of vodka, which was about three quarters full, only to find the rest of the group gathered around on the balcony in utter silence at the amount of money that they'd spent on the first day. With it annoying one of our friends that much that the following morning, he went to the supermarket to buy a loaf of bread, butter, and ham for the rest of the holiday. Didn't they, Dan? Apart from that, the rest of the stag went to plan, and the 17 of us all made it home safely, surprisingly. Now, not only was I invited to the stag, I was also invited to the hen. But not only did I make it into the WhatsApp group chat to help plan it, I was also invited to a secret photo album. That when they arrived in Mykonos, I thought, what's this? So, which, if I do say on behalf of myself and everyone who went to the stag that saw these photos, you all look lovely. And Lucy, you definitely can dance.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah. Now, not only did Matt have a stag in Dubai, Matt also wanted to have a get-together back home for all the family and friends who didn't love him that much to make the journey over to Dubai with the rest of us. Now, Matt chose Dubai for a number of reasons. One, because he has an expensive taste. Two, for the fact that it'd probably price a few out that you didn't want to come anyway. And three, for the sheer fact that it would mean he would be stitched up as little as possible. Despite dressing him up in a few stupid outfits and getting him to do a few shots on nights out, it's fair to say he got away with it pretty lightly. Now, I actually wanted the home stag to be different. I spent the week prior to this trying to sort all sorts of things to make it as painful as possible. However, despite fighting with me, I accepted he just wanted to have a casual couple of beers with friends and family, which he agreed he would wear an outfit, but that was it. For those of you who didn't see the outfit, it was disgusting. He was a fully kitted out goth with black nails, eyeliner and nose rings. Everyone met in Hartford, and after a solid day session of drinking and being tied to Sabby for 3 hours with an iPhone lightning cable, who was constantly making him drink, by 10 o'clock Matt was finished and slipped off. At this point, we had all assumed Matt was on his way home and in bed and would wake up in the morning full of life and be grateful that this was all over with. However, this was not the case. Me and Lonsdale left practitioner around 12, and we were saying how happy we were that it was a decent time as he had a flight to catch at 7 in the morning. We were about 3 minutes away from my house when I received a text from Georgia saying that she needed some help as Matt had fallen over in the toilet and smashed his eye open and there was blood everywhere. Me and Lonsdale turned up like rapid response, only to see our victim laying in the bed, hair spiked like Gareth Gates, with a big grin on his face. However, the same couldn't be said for Georgia. She was absolutely disgusted to see that her husband-to-be now looked like he'd just done 3 rounds with Tyson Fury just 6 days before their wedding day. And to make it worse, he found it hilarious in front of his mates. Despite wanting to help him, I honestly believe if me and Ben hadn't turned up when we did, we wouldn't be stood here today. Now, I think you'll all agree, Georgia, you look absolutely beautiful today. Yeah. And I can have... And I can hand on heart say that I couldn't think of a better person for my best friend to be spending the rest of his life with. I'd also like to say thank you, because since you've come into his life, you've taken him off my hands. Because if it wasn't for you, I would still be spending my weekends doing lifts for random people, charging ridiculous amounts of money, to which, if I remember rightly, is exactly how you two met. Matt had picked up Georgia from a party, and despite being attracted to her, he remembered his love for money. Upon pulling up to what was the biggest house we had both ever seen, with big gates in front and a driveway that looked like a small car park, he decided to up the fare and, and charge her £50 for a journey that was no more than 10 minutes. I'm sure this wasn't just this that kept Matt coming back. All of you who know Georgia know she is a wonderful, caring person and truly deserves a good husband. So thank God you met her before she found one, mate. Now, all jokes aside, I'm really happy that you two today have become husband and wife. And over the past 10 years, I've watched the two of you grow and better each other's lives in so many ways. I'm sure everyone here today will join me in wishing you many more years of happiness. If we could all raise a glass to the new Mr. and Mrs. Brickland.